be road, because I have finished the road from this tower to the other tower. Hello, everybody. Welcome to episode 57, I believe. I'm pretty sure, like, every episode. I'm not sure what episode it is, but I get it right anyway. Anyways, I'm going to show you the road that I made here. So, obviously, we made this road in the past, leading up to this tower, a watchtower. In case you missed last episode, from this watchtower, we notice that in the distance, and I don't have my render distance all the way up. Hello, phone. I don't have my render distance high enough because I'm using shaders right now just to show off what we're building. We can see that there is a warning light in the tower to the west, or I think this is the west. And the tower is clearly in a state of ruin. So we're going to find out what is going on around there. I'm going to turn my render distance back down for the sake of frame rates. Don't worry, guys. I keep saying it, but building a new computer soon. It'll be able to run this stuff, no problem. Anyways, so I made this road. Comes down here. My tip is that if you make a road like this that's just going across the country, make it pretty easy to follow. So, like, I kind of ran into difficulty right here where it was going through stone that I couldn't really see the road. So I added this wall here, and I added some shrubbery. I bone mealed around the path pretty much the whole way there. Put bushes, you know, like, here, like, just to make this little water area, little pond type deal, just a little bit more interesting. Comes out this way. I added torch lights so at nighttime you can see, and it makes it quite a bit more interesting. It goes on up here. Remember, if you're going uphill, make it winding, just like a real hiking path. It doesn't go straight up a hill, right? But it comes out this way. You get a pretty good view down here and up here to the watchtower. So today, we're going to find out what did this, what made this mess. And before we do that, I'm going to go sleep. And I've already set up and prepared for what we're going to do today. So let's just jump down here. The moon is showing through the world, but that's okay. Woo! I love feather falling. And it's daytime. I've got the shaders off. I've got the render distance up and the fog short. I really like this way. I think it's because you can't see the end of your rendering, which isn't really a problem here because we're kind of surrounded by mountains. Every way you look, there's hills. But you can't really see the end of where I can render. So the fog kind of hides the border. It looks really nice. It gets rid of those ugly unrendered chunks that we were just looking at. Anyways, here's where we are. Really not that far from the farming village. You saw me just now take the walk from there. I think this might technically be the same plains biome. I think it winds around if we go over this way and look over the plains. There's lots of good area here for building in. But I'm kind of like, my thing that I want to do is like kind of make this world more spread out and interesting and connected through roads and whatnot. Cool little spire there. But you can see the tower right there. And so we're assuming that the whatever did this came from a projectile of some sort. And we're going to build what made that projectile today. And I've got pretty much everything in my inventory that I need. Excuse me. Got a burp that I'm going to need. And it's going to be a stone golem, an earth golem, an earth sprite, something between a golem and a sprite. And there's going to be a story behind it, but I think we're going to get into the story after it's built. So I kind of want to get rid of this granite. Well, we need a good flat area. Ooh, this could be good right here. So I've tested out one of these, building one of these in creative. So I don't have like a perfect like blueprint. In fact, I'm not even looking at it. But what I did was I did something like, let's put down dirt so I'm not wasting. I had. I built the frame of it as if you were like drawing a stick figure. Right? So I built the frame. And I don't really want to build it on a diagonal though. It doesn't need to be on a diagonal. Would it be better to look this way or that way? Or do we have room? Maybe it would be better to put it right here because I don't want it on a diagonal. Although putting it on one would probably open up some pretty interesting possibilities. But let's just do it right here. So right now I'm building what is supposed to be the leg. So this one's kneeling, kind of. So this is like his knee right here, and then the bottom of his leg goes this way, and it comes in, right? So like this, and it's pretty big. Let's just do, his hip is going to be like 3 wide, right? And then let's kind of do his spine, and it's going to be like an arching back. I don't know if you're following what I'm doing at all. Let's put down the other leg, and then you can, like, clearly see what I'm trying to accomplish. So remember, I'm not like, working on... Let's get rid of that and that for now. Just want the frame. I'm not making his limbs straight, because it's not going to look good if I do. And just bringing that straight down. So that's, like, a leg stepping forward. And I almost want to get rid of that. No. I definitely want that coming out here. So that's like his knee. But I kind of want his hip further out. Well, we can flesh that out when we... Because this is just like the skeleton. So let's get away up here. And this is like his arching back, which is going to be covered in grass. Which is going to be kind of like one of his key features. So something like this, and then, I want to put his face, I'm trying to decide if I want his face right there or one more out. Let's bring it one more out. I'm trying to get more into studying art, like drawing. Like, I'm pretty good at drawing, but I never pursued it because I didn't think it was something that I would like ever be able to grind out all day as a job. And I'm looking into buying a tablet and like doing studies on my own time, like drawing studies. And like, I don't know, I'm kind of like thinking in a new way while I'm building this, like just as proportions and whatnot instead of as detail. And then I'm going to flesh it out as detail later. But obviously, you can do like a project like this, think about it in quite a few different ways. So this is going to be his face. I'm just going to make it a flat. If I have stairs with me, I know... No, I don't. I could make his face with stairs if I had him with me. Okay, so that's his back. That's his face, his legs. Let's throw in his arms. And that's how he threw what I'm going to say is a boulder. He threw a boulder up there. And... Let's kind of make shoulders, just for framework. Some of this not necessarily going to stay. But, okay, I don't think... One of these is going to go down, and one of them is going to be up. It's kind of hard to really explain my thoughts here. But I think the pose is going to be really important. Because if you just have, like, his arms the exact same, like, symmetrical, it's probably not going to look good. This is going to be... I'm going to have, like, one arm going down and one... not like one even, or you could have one up high. Hello, Discord, can you please stop? I don't know if my thing is recording the sound from that. I think it is, but Discord, please shut up. I'm trying to think. Okay, so I may take a moment to think. I'm gonna like finish this on camera, the skeleton of it, and I may like take a moment to look at it, but this one's gonna be brought down in a very similar way. Let's just do... I know I'm wasting stone, but... Shut up. I want to bring that out more. Now I'm trying to decide if I want to bring it... I want to bring it out. definitely, but I don't know if I want to bring it to the right more, to his left. I think I want to bring it to his left one more block and down. So that would bring it, I'd bring it right here. Right? And then right here. And then we'll give him like fingers so you can tell that those are hands. So this is kind of like, with buildings, we've had experience that you're not necessarily going to be happy with what you're building while you're building it. It's going to kind of like flesh itself out. And this is definitely one of those cases. I think what I don't like about this is that I want it sticking out more. Maybe something like this. Because I want that to be clearly like a step forward. Like he steps forward with this foot while throwing with this hand a boulder up there. All right. The next thing that I think that I want to do is the back, because that really doesn't depend on the posture at all. That's kind of going to be the same no matter what. So it's pretty much just going to be a grass dome. So I'm going to climb up there and let's time lapse this one. That looks pretty good. One thing that I did notice while I was doing this, that arm looked pretty short, and it's one block longer than this one. I might extend this one. But it was like too close to the body, and the shell was over it, and I didn't like that. Now, some of this is dirt, and it needs to turn into grass, so I can get those grass textures on the side. It'll look a lot better. And then I'll put like leaves and everything. That'll look a lot better too. So let's get onto the legs, I guess. Well, yeah, let's do the legs. So I kind of just want to do it all in stone to start with. And then I'm going to mix up the textures with, I have cyan clay and andesite. I didn't want anything too contrasting for this project because I kind of just want it to look like a mixture of rocks, not like, I want gravel or, well, gravel would be fine. I don't want granite in here. It's just not what I'm going for. So, what to do here? Let's definitely make this, like, I definitely need to make this wider. I'm just trying to figure out what direction, like, don't just make everything super blocky. Like, that looks all right. I'm actually going to pull this out like that. And put that there. And there. See, now that resembles like a kneecap, kind of. You might want to, like, be tempted to put that there. I think that could look fine. I don't think it necessarily needs it. I think for the sake of our overall shape, it looks fine. This hip definitely needs something. Let's try, get the bow off of here. I'm not building with my bow. I'm kind of looking at the thighs, thinking what direction would the meat of the thighs be in. See, looking at that, I definitely want something right here. I want, now this is a foot, not kneeling, so I kind of want, do I have a slab on me? I kind of want to put a slab, kind of like make this like toes. So if we do this, bring this, and I'm kind of like filling this in with like up close, right? Which is kind of strange. Like, I feel like I can see things just there when I got close that I wasn't seeing before. All right, now this block needs to go because I'm kind of like visioning in my mind how I want it to look. I want it to look more like this, and right now it's giving me this kind of feeling. So get rid of you. Now this joint right here looks too thin. So, see if I can climb up here. Let's go there. But like, I kind of want this gone. So you can sit here and sculpt. And that's what it is. It's sculpting, except with sculpting, you're trying to find something within what you're chipping away at. This I'm like adding to it. I kind of want that block pushed back. And that can probably go there. Yeah, that looks fine for the legs, I think. Let's add this for a toe. And now let's go on to the body. Now we have a way to get up here. This is fun. I haven't built anything like this really before. Let's just... this dirt needs to go. And we can add more dirt other than just on the top. But, this whole, like... I need, like, some sort of body here. Let's make the arms so that we know our parameters for the body. Because we don't want to... oops. We don't want to build a body and then realize that's too close to the arms. Well, let's do the fingers sort of like this. You're going to be on diagonal. Like so. Let's put them right here. And here. No. Because that would like... if this were like a human hand, that would put the thumb. I'm thinking like that's a thumb. That would put that on the outside, so that would be weird. I don't want that. Gonna have to jump down. Knock it away. Just gonna step back and look at it. A lot of this is stepping back and looking at it. Yeah, I wonder if there's any way that we can simulate like, hey, that's a... he's holding a boulder. I've kind of like thought about what if you added a boulder mid-air, you know, like he just threw it, but at the same time, I don't really like the idea that it's just perpetually there to us, like we'd be frozen in time, that would be the idea, obviously, but I just don't really think that it works that great for us, so let's bring this down, and his shoulder probably needs some meat on the back end, and then his arm's probably pretty good. His forearm doesn't need to be huge, I don't think. Let's actually add one here, and we'll take a look. That's pretty minimalistic. I remember adding quite a bit more, a few more blocks on my test one. Now that makes me want to get rid of this. But this one's pretty simple, and I like it. I kind of want to add one on top of that block. Hope you guys don't mind this being an episode that we do a lot of building together in. Usually I try to do a lot of my thinking process off camera. Yeah, that's pretty good. Then we can bring in the body from that. Now this arm... the hand's going to be very similar. In fact, I'll probably just do it the exact same, just mirrored. So let's get our dirt in here for placing our blocks. And it's almost nighttime. I'll probably finish up this body here as the sun goes down. So yeah, I'll get back to you guys in a little bit. The overall shape of it. I did quite a bit of revising to the actual abdomen. The arms, I think, are pretty good. from this angle. I mean, let's take a look around. Like, from the back, I really like it. You can tell that he's, like, has a dome back. Actually, I'm glad I came back there because I'm not happy with this. Let me... I don't know, this spine, it's sticking out too much on its own. Something like that. And let's do the same on this side. I really need more than 10 slots, or I need to not have 5 tools taking up all my slots. Where, what could I use? Let's use that. Okay, so try to mirror there. Yeah, that'll be good. Let's climb down and... Oh, hello? Okay, now there's a block there. Sometimes if you, like, replace a block over a ghosted block, it will fill up. Otherwise, next time I relog, that'll be there. So that'll be a pain in the butt. I like that more. Although... That kind of makes me want to bring down the dirt a little bit more. Do I have any grass on me? A little. Let's go up and do something like this. No. Like this. Same thing on this side. Oh, we only need it on one spot this side because of the way that the arm be. There. So yeah, just take a look at what you're building. So once that all grows in, that looks pretty good. That's a shell. That looks like a shell. So this guy's a golem, right? Let's give him a face. And then we'll give him a story. Actually, there's a little bit more to do after before we give him a story. But these are going to be his eyes. Then his mouth is going to be these. And let's go on up here, make his head a little rounded. Let's just do one of these deals. And we should probably put stone back here. Right there. Climb down and take a look at our beautiful friend. Oh, stop doing that. I'm gonna relog. That's our beautiful new friend. He probably has his name, a name. He probably has friends that call him something, but I don't know what that is. Let's grab some cyan. When I like to just kind of throw in blocks to make everything textured, I kind of do it one block at a time. Even when I'm... Hello? Wait, no. Right there? Was that not where I said it? Even when I do roads, I like to dig out the whole road and then just spam one kind of block. And then I'll go back, spam another kind instead of... switching back and forth. I think it saves you quite a bit of time. So we're just... I'm not thinking too much about it. Just kind of spreading them out. Doing it the way I do. Let's add more on this side. And I do have a story for him, too. You guys are going to like it. For those of you that don't know, I'm trying to implement more of a story into my builds lately. And pretty much everything that I'm building lately is story-driven. So instead of doing a whole town, I'm kind of doing like a side quest where our towns are the main story and this is a side quest to the town, right? Like if it were a video game. So now I want andesite and then we should be good to move on to the vegetation stage. Oh gosh, that's not what I wanted. Right there. So... I added some grass into the knee just to add more green all around. Not too complicated, just mixing up the colors, really. Let's put that there. And this isn't mixing up colors as much as it's just mixing up texture, but it gets the job done. And add some to the front of this leg, and then we're more or less good. Like, I can replace this, maybe. All of his fingers are stone, but that's okay. I don't really feel like climbing up there and placing a block to place a block. So that's what he looks like for now. Now let's do some vegetation next. Get this off, and I have a bunch of bone meal. I stayed up the other night just fighting off skeletons so that I could just have a bunch of bone meal. I don't want any flowers, really. It would be a cool Bastion reference if I put a flower on his shoulder or on his forearm or wherever that flower is. Gosh, this is so much easier and creative when I can just fly around. Go sleep. Oh, gosh. Yeah, don't think too hard about the vegetation. I'm just putting down bone meal, and then we're going to take leaves. And I got two different kinds of leaves just because that's what I've been doing lately. If you were doing a larger golem, I would definitely say go ahead and put a tree on here. And I was like kind of doing research, like Googling pictures of people's, drawings and whatnot, trying to get inspiration. And I did see a lot of them with trees on their back. I don't think that you'd, the proportions probably won't look right on something this small. This isn't a tree-bearing golem. It's just covered in weeds. Let's add some to his belly, maybe. I kind of want to add some green over here. Just, like, maybe here and there. I don't have vines on me, but I'd add them. Yeah, that looks good. Another thing that we could do is, he's throwing rocks, obviously. What if, I'm going to need some half slabs for this. What if we made some, like, piles of rocks that he's, like, grabbing from? I don't know where how he got him here. I don't know how he got here. Well, I know how. You guys don't know how. I got to throw something away. You might notice my banners. That's something that we're getting to. I have too many arrows. I have an infinity arrow, so I'm always accidentally doing that, taking up space. So let's just do something like this. You guys will know what this is. I don't know if I should probably like try to make a goal that if like just random person saw this, they would know what it is. Like, you could know that he's grabbing from a pile of rocks there, right? Maybe. What was the last thing? Oh yeah, I'm gonna need fence for this last part. So, I don't think I will. Let's take you over to the creative world. Okay, here's my test golem. I added more dirt under his belly, huh? But for the most part, see, this is why you don't need a blueprint for this. You can see all kinds of interesting things I've messed around with, can't you? you don't really need a blueprint for this because I clearly just like winged it both times and they came out pretty similar. As long as you're doing the hunched back and the face like this and the hands and the feet, it's going to look like this guy. This is the thing that I was kind of wanting to do, where it's kind of like a war banner, but I don't think that's really going to fit his story here. And I don't really like the way it looks. Like, it's an interesting concept. I mean, I kind of like it. I don't know. I'm very, very unsure about that banner, but he does look very similar. And the last touch to add a story. I've got Ender Pearls. I have a bunch of them. I don't know why I wasn't using them. Let's go on up here. Awesome. I didn't overshoot. So I want somewhere to place this chest. Somewhere ideally in the back. In his back. I guess just right here. I guess. And we're going to put a book in here. And I haven't written in it, but we know what it says. But for now, all that we know about this book, we found this book when we came to investigate this tower, and we found this guy. And I guess we defeated this guy, so I could have made this guy, like, dead. I don't know. Or maybe he's, like, somehow been turned to stone by the guards, like, not full of life stone, but regular stone, by the guards from the farm village. And they found this, and it's a pact, a summoning pact. And it's in another language. It's going to need some transcribing or research done by the wizard of the town. The only thing that they seem to be able to gather from this book right now is that this guy seems to have been summoned by a man named Leohorn the Wizard. And I used an online Dungeons & Dragons name generator to come up with that. But it's Leohorn the Wizard. So next episode, we're going to take that to the town, bring it to the wizard in his tower in the Farmer's Guild. And we're going to find out a little bit more about this guy. Where he came from, who sent him, why they sent him. Who knows? We're interested. Tune in next time. Bye.